So here I have scraps of fabric that I had screen printed. I just simply pieced them together, played a little bit more with some paint, and I have a little quilt top big enough to wrap up my book.
Okay.
Now I take a little bit of batting.
And that looks like it's like a little off top bottom.
Yeah, what just something flat and easy, not something slippery. It needs to stick just a little bit.
Okay.
And at this point, I will do whatever quilting I like. So let's play a little bit.
So, but you don't have your backing fabric yet.
Backing.
So just through the batting.
Okay. Yeah. Top, middle, nothing on the back.
Great.
Let's go over and do a little bit of free motion quilting. I have a free motion quilting foot set up. And
the feed dogs are down.
Feed dogs are down. Let's get things going on.
You picked a thread that looks like a high contrast thread.
This time you can choose whatever thread that you want to play with. I'm going to emphasize the circular design here and just play around a little bit. You know, whatever you choose to put on your design, it doesn't really matter.
We would have to let that golden break.
So once you have your whole thing, this one's just straight lines, easy to go.
Mm-hmm.
Again, just the backing, no batting. Now we need to do a little bit of measuring, but not very much measuring.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm using a Sharpie, so you can see as well. You can use a chalk pencil.
So normally you use a chalk pencil, which so people can see clearly what it is. And you're outlining the edges of the book.
Outlining three sides of the book.
Okay.
And then carefully roll it up.
You've got to leave space for the spine.
Yeah, leave space for the spine. And then over we go and do the other side.
And now have you added left a half an inch to the outside of this? Is that right?
When you trim is when you decide how much seam allowance you need. This is when you put the backing. And then you're going to need a little bit of extra. And I will put that just in the middle anywhere. And I will just eyeball it.
Okay.
No rulers, no.
So what you're aiming for is about a half an inch to the outside of that line you want.
Exactly.
Okay.
About a half an inch all the way around.
Now, so you added that extra little piece inside there because you're cutting it down a size too?
Yeah, you need it.
That's your secret to this technique.
Same length there. So
when you put it in there, you only have to cover that center area with that? Roughly cover the center area?
We'll get there.
Okay. I'll ask you two questions.
Yes. So we've got it all trimmed exactly neatly.
Mm-hmm.
So I've trimmed the backing to the same size, and this is the same length.
Okay.
And then we reverse it. We put right sides together.
Mm-hmm.
So my backing is actually going to flip and be in the middle. And this is the trick. This is the super easy fun part. All we do is divide the fabric in half, and then we cut it in half. And you know what?
You can crease it in half.
Oh,
give me a basket.
I'm so awful.
You just cut it 10 seconds off the time.
I did. And then I didn't even go to an iron.
You
fingerpress both edges back. Now, if you have a fat spine on your book, you need to finger press a little bit more. You need to make sure that your book will fit in there.
Okay.
Because these are the claps for the inside of the book.
And now you're trying to get that out, too.
Now is when that extra piece comes into play. It just has to be wide enough to cover up those claps.
Okay, great.
But again, this is so easy.
I think you're starting to finish the edges.
Right. So now we need to sew all the way around all four corners. We're going back over to the machine. And this time, I love using a walking foot. Because I'm too lazy to pin, it's easier to put a walking foot on.
And with the walking foot, too, even if you pin it, sometimes it can slide a little bit. And
right.
What the walking foot does is allow both of the pieces to be together so that one doesn't slide a little bit and everything's off.
That's exactly it. Now, I don't start right in the corner. I start off to the edge. And I know we cut a half an inch seam allowance, but I'm only sewing a quarter inch seam allowance to start with. All the way around the edges. I get to my corner. I go kind of off the edge. And then I come back. And notice I haven't done exactly a 45 degree angle. Well, I did. But now I go back and I like to cut off that tip just a little bit, go back and forth a couple times before I move on.
Is that to reinforce the corner so the book
it reinforces the corner. I'll show you what's up next.
Okay, let's go all the way around. Look at the corner and what you did here. Because I want to make sure people can see this. You've just stitched back and forth a little bit. There's a 45 degree angle right at the corner.
Right at the corner. And this is why. Now we go and we trim everything very nice and neatly and snip very closely. the outside of it, right to the outside of that reinforced stitching. And what that does, even though it's not a very sharp corner, it gives enough room on the inside for the extra fabric to slide in there.
Uh-huh. And you're cutting to a quarter of an inch.
Now I'm cutting kind of to a quarter of an inch. Really, I'm just sniffing off those edges.
Right.
So now we can turn it inside out. We sew it all the way around the edge without leaving an opening, but there's a magic opening right here. The way I turn it inside out is I stick my thumb tight in each corner and really pop it out before I get the rest of it.
Yeah.
And then...
so fun to turn inside out.
Here we go. This is the magic tongue.
And do you use a little tool to push that corner? Or
yeah, that once I get my fingernails in there.
Uh-huh. It's enough.
Pop. There we go.
Okay, that's great. And then would you press it at this point?
The way I press is I kind of just finger press each of those bits out.
Uh-huh.
So the seams lay flat, and then we're going to go back around, and you can skip this step if you want to, but we're going to go back around and edge stitch.
No,
we're going
to use
one of my favorite
edge stitch. Okay.
So once again, here we go, changing foots, and edge stitching foot has this lovely little guide along with it that shows you exactly, I use it all the time for construction.
I think I just wanted to have that for you.
We're going to gently butterfly the book.
That's true. They wouldn't like that, would they?
All right. Yeah. So we get it in part way,
uh-huh.
And then just slide it down.
It's like putting on pants.
There you go.
Looks beautiful.
And there we go.
This is one of the easiest ways I've seen.